Good evening and welcome to the special town meeting being held to primarily deal with budget issues because of the failed override. Our first order of business is to have the town clerk read the posting of the warrant.
I have notified and informed the inhabitants of the town of Sunderland by posting up existing copies of the same. Frederick A. Thorne is constable, May 24, 2017, and May 25.
Thank you. One order of business. I'd like to have a motion so that if one of the third article in tonight's meeting requires a two-thirds vote, and I'd like to be able to call that if I feel that it's reached the two-thirds rather than have a count. If somebody isn't happy with the way I call it, then we can make a petition for a recount. So it's just a way of expediting the meeting. So if someone would make a motion to that effect, I would appreciate it. The motion's been made and seconded. Everybody say aye.
Aye.
One of the things that I noticed on the way in tonight that I thought was rather cool is, I'm not, don't know who's responsible for it, but did you folks notice the art on the way in on the windowsills that were made out of paper bags, all the little trees and flowers? I thought that was the neatest looking things, and I guess it's a reflection on the quality of education that our students get here in the elementary school. So whoever's responsible for it, it really looks great and it's a real nice job. Okay. I guess we're ready.
Part of that and giving back to the town.
I don't know if that answers your question. I think people are concerned with the money we asked for. Yeah, and is that...
I would be concerned as to what the process is by which the money will eventually be returned, as to whether, I mean, I'm only asking for 65, I mean, we struggle over budgets in this town, and even 65,000, while it's less, a lot less than 105, is still a big chunk of change. Okay, and if, you know, I'm delighted to hear, which I've understood, that there would be a lot of donations given, that we're gonna cover a lot of these costs, and also that there's gonna be, if the need in some instances for money in advance to, like, you know, book places and things like that, so on. But, you know, is there some sort of, normally you have a pretty firm procedure as to how the money that's gonna be coming back actually gets back to make sure that when all is said and done, you know, that really happens. And I wondered if you thought about that, if the finance committee has thought about that, and what you might have come up with.
What I can tell you from our committee is, we do get checks from people, we turn them into our treasurer for the committee, and she turns them into the town, and they process all of that money, and I don't know the ins and outs of the money of the town, how the town handles it, but it goes back to the town treasurer.
Is there a revolving fund for this?
No. That's a special revenue fund. That's a special revenue fund, so I think everything's closed out of its surplus and reverse free cash.
Can you get that?
Sure.
Yeah, it's set up as a special revenue fund, so it can take in revenues from a variety of sources, including the town. So at the end of the exercise, if all the books are cleaned and closed, bills are paid, whatever the town's committed, the town receives back in free cash if there's anything left over. Again, not a revolving, but special revenue.
And do you have any expectation as to how much might be turned back when this is all said and done?
We are asking for $65,000, and that is at this point the bare essentials that to take and run the parade, to take and hire the bands. We're going to take and set up Brenda and the parade committee has taken and offered, well, they've got the information for the tent setup on a Friday, Saturday, and Sunday for the start of our celebration. June 15th, this parade is on the 16th, and then on the 17th. The tent and infrastructure there is going to be made available to the elementary school for a Friday evening event. The parade is going to be using that afterwards for an after parade event where we're going to be planning on setting up the fireworks that Saturday night. And Sunday we have a talk from the fire department that day too, we'll be having a chicken barbecue. All of that stuff that I just mentioned, we are asking for donations to take and supplement the cost of it. The parade committee has been on for a year already looking for funding to take and sponsor some of the bands and other things. And so we're looking that even anyone that's been going to take and use the tent on Friday, Saturday, and or Sunday, that they take and they kick in a little bit to take and for the usage of the tent and the support. We have a weekend of events coming up in October, and most of those are going to be funded, self-funded. So mainly what we're looking at this point here is some seed money. And from that seed money, we are then taking and sponsoring some stuff, but also getting money back from volunteers, from donations in the town. I cannot take and say at this time here exactly what we're going to get back from donations, but if donations don't, you know, we're doing our best. And we're trying to give you the best quality 300th anniversary program as possible. And as we started off with $100,000, like Brenda said, these were all the things that we came up with that, and we put a price tag on it. We looked, we saw, we put a price tag on it, we worked with our bookkeeper and that, and this is what, you know, it's going to cost. Yes, we're selling souvenirs. Yes, we're looking to make some money from that. How many souvenirs we're going to sell, we don't know at this point here. But we're not going to take and overbuy. The souvenir committee is going to take and just take and purchase small amounts, sell them, and then when you sell out, to take and reorder again. So I think at this point here, I can credit to the 300th anniversary committee, we've been meeting every other, the first Thursday of every month. We're keeping very, very tight budgets. But to take and offer a program like this, to take and give the town citizens what they ask for, we're doing the best we can for, for a limited amount of money. So that's it. That's all I can take and tell you right now. I'm a taxpayer in town, along with everyone else on the committee. We're doing the best we can to keep the cost down. We're knocking on doors, we're rattling cages, we've got some cans out here, look, we're getting those guys in waters, we're doing the best we can. And that's all. Thank you.
Just one more thing, Bob. Have you given any thought, or maybe you already have plans to do monthly check-ins with the Board of Selectmen to, keep them abreast of the progress and or the Finance Committee?
At this point here, we do have a member of the Select Board on our committee. He's been attending the meetings, and he's been keeping us abreast of the attitude of the town members and that stuff, and then also keeping us abreast of the donation that we asked for this State Senator Cooler. And yes, we have applied for money from him. Yes, we have applied for money from all the other people, that stuff. But once again, we're talking, it's a year down the road at this point here. And it's like, okay, we're waiting, and hopefully we'll get some answers from the state shortly, along with some other people. But, there it is. But Town Funding Evans is on our board.
Okay, thank you.
He's keeping us very informed. Right, John?
Anyone else? All those in favor of Article 1, please say aye.
Aye.
All those opposed, nay. They're unanimous. Article 2. Made and seconded for Article 2, which is to try and get the budget, not try, but to get the budget back into balance. Any discussion?
Right now it's about 190,000 or 195,000.
Thank you. Anyone else? Peter?
A couple of things here that you're recommending reducing. I hope you can explain briefly. One was town building, $6,000. Can you hear me?
Sure, if I could, Peter. It's a good question. On the building side, there's three lines out of the detail budget. One of them is the telephone expense line. The reason we're anticipating that being reduced in the coming year is through the process of a community compacts grant, and we're going to a new home system, so we're pretty comfortable with those savings. That's $2,000. Our building maintenance line of $1,000, and then our energy contingency of $3,000. That's specific. That's all how to capture the energy. Phones are kind of a big amount. That's a capital lease. That's a frankly grant. You know, you share a lot of credit for that. And that's when saving us for not getting those off of current part of the line system and doing the worst of the grant.
So in fact, that's already been, that's going to be taken care of rather than something that customers not doing that we.
Yeah, that's a good question. We anticipate those cost reductions carrying forward. It's not just this year and coming back.
How about the $10,000 connection to the service?
That's risky business.
That's good. Actually, that's a line item. I'm not sure what the numbers would be if you basically put in a $10,000 lower number. It's not going to change the fact of what we actually spent.
You raise a great point. The treasurer collector was actually pretty clear this year that it was important that we actually adjusted up. This is a reduction of the adjustment up. There's still an increase in that line over the year on year. And I say this in the context of this current budget cycle. We've actually had to move money into that.
And it's going up because of the medical insurance costs?
Yes, primarily medical insurance costs.
And we can't predict those because we don't know what employees are going to take what money, correct?
Exactly. Or if there's staff turnover and someone switches,
right?
And it's interesting again because the treasurer collector came this year through the original budget submission through our working meeting with her, and it really, you know, held a firm footing when we came back and said, well, how about if we go down to an increase of one family plan and budget for that as opposed to the three that they were targeting?
Well, was that the original budget?
That was hundred.
And now you're going to $10,000 total. Is that reasonable?
It'll get us through the year.
I don't want to get us through the year because we have to make up for it at the end of the year after we have the account, right?
Well, again, there's an increase in the line, and it's not allocated for any growth. So covering this year's cost in anticipation of enrollment plus one potential for next year. So there's some in there, but not as much as what we started with the original budget. But again, great question. Since we start talking about insurance, it is a bit of a fact. We did have five people leave.
The $10,000 reduction to the school?
Actually, it's 12.
I'm sorry,
12. Yeah, hold on. One of those handsome devils right there,
Tom.
Here you go.
Did you have a specific question?
Yeah, I mean, we're cutting away by $12,000. And I was wondering whether there's been any discussion about what that meant. I'm just a voter, I'd like to know what's going on. Because we failed to pass the $300,000 override, and I turn around, we're cutting the budget by $37,000. Okay, now, I don't really be happier than that. It's just actually a drain.
Well, I'll talk specifically to the school budget. I could talk to that part that we just talked about, that we talked about in numerous select board meetings that I attended. But to the school budget first, we did get some tuition money that helps us in the short term for this year's budget. And cut supplies for this coming year's budget. We do, as Tom was just saying, have a bigger issue with the budget. And I'm glad to see that the 200 and some people who voted no are here to maybe help us figure that out. You know, for the school, as I said here at the town meeting in April, you know, in the last 5 years, our resident population has gone up by about, in K-6, by about 50 kids, almost 40% increase in the school. It costs more money to educate them. We're going to have this year to look at some tough choices. If there's not another solution for the budget, I'd love to have some help with that from folks. What we did talk about, obviously, this year, as the Select Board talked about at town meeting, in numerous meetings, we have a favorable free cash situation this year, which helped make things not as painful as they otherwise would be this year. We all know what's looming, and so we sought to not wait and that sought an override for this year because, I asked for that as well coming from the school because we've been through it before where we had a couple of weeks to figure out what we were cutting, and that's a worse situation than, you know, the not very desirable situation that I'm in now. No, we were asking for $12,000 less from the town. Partly we got some money in for tuition, which reduces what we need to ask from the town, and we cut the line item for supplies. So, I mean, obviously, what we ask the town for is our total budget, and one of the things I also talk about is, you know, we use school choice funds to reduce what we ask from the town appropriation. That's what's part of what's been allowing us to put off, as the resident, the number of kids we've had in the school has been going up dramatically over the last 5 years. The amount we've been asking for from the town hasn't gone up nearly as dramatically, and a lot of that is because we've been using school choice funds. We're at the limit of that. In fact, we have to back off of that, which is part of why we're in a really tough position next year.
So could we have a clarification on the school choice funding? Will we take a student in on school choice? Do we get some funds from that? Right? Is it still like $12,000 or something? It's $5,000? $5,000? And how much does it cost to pay for that student?
So
what's the cost to educate that person?
I'll give it back to you.
So, not all per pupil is around $13,000. It's not like we're adding classrooms and filling them up with school choice students. We're filling up classrooms when we're in a situation, or when we're in a situation like we've recently been in with kindergarten, where it's got to be more than one classroom. At that point, to bring in school, you know, to add kids to school choice and get that money, the marginal money we get on school choice is greater than the marginal that we're getting for the kids. We wouldn't try to do a whole class. I mean, Deerfield was just in a position of, they got so far down on school choice that effectively they were doing a whole classroom in a grade of school choice, and that now was not enough.
I'm not sure if you answered any of this. Have you really done an analysis to see how the puts and takes really go in terms of we've got these dollars coming in for the new students, and we figured out what it really costs to pay for the students that you have now? I haven't seen that. Yeah, it shows the fact that we are financially coming ahead by taking students in.
Well, like I said, as soon as we have to go to another classroom, so now we've got another classroom teacher, right? It's already there, we already have to pay for it without taking those school choice kids, right? So, if... Exactly, at a certain point we would be going past, and that's why every year when we work through this with the principal, we take all of it into account.
And did you take into account when you start a student, they're allowed to stay here until they get into the graduating class? So we have a commitment. Making our population grow. Because every year we bring in a new group of kids at elementary, I think, I mean, they're going to stay there and do it. So aren't you sort of self-propelling yourself and move
forward? You should have your kids. Right, so come to our meetings, really. You want to go through the stuff with us, we do go through it in great detail, and about the school choice and all these considerations. We understand that they're going to be with us. We understand we don't want to put ourselves in a position where now all of a sudden we would go to another classroom. I think we probably should do more.
I'll tell you, it would be easier if we got reports from the school system. This item in the budget is our biggest item, right? $2.5 million. It's one line. So, there's a much bigger report that's done every year on the school system. Where
is it?
Where
is
that?
Central
office? Oh,
great.
We have a perfect place for this stuff. It's called our annual report.
So, we should
add to the budget to get all our reports online.
What was the question?
Do we know where the $12,000 is coming from?
We don't have to take in, and we don't in every grade, you know, more resident kids to come in, because we don't want it to all of a sudden lead us into a third class. Yeah.
Thank you.
Yeah.
Anyone else? Okay. All those in favor of the budget changes as listed in Article 2, please say aye.
Aye.
All those opposed, nay. Declare by majority. Okay, Article 3.
I'd like to move Article 3. Second.
Article 3 is the moved and seconded. Any discussion? Okay. Georgia? Yes, see, turn us left out again, huh? Softball?
Well, the balance is Bob.
Right now, we're having some issues with our fuel pumps that we have at the station. Put it in back in early 90s, I think. The gas pump itself vaporizes when it gets really hot out. And when you pump fuel out of it, you have to cycle it like four or five times, and then you might get the fuel to come out of it. It's broken right now, so. And then, the main towel, the computer in it, gets locked up a couple times this year. I did it a few times in a row, and it hasn't done it probably in a month now. And when they reset the computer, and they, according to the company, they say you really shouldn't have to be doing that all the time. So there's some kind of glitch that's going on with that too. You know, it's pumped 13 gallons of fuel out of that thing. The time that it's been there, it's probably going to be replaced. This money's diesel and gas.
Anyone else? All right.
All those in favor
of a new fuel pump, please say aye.
Aye.
Okay, we need one last motion.
Second.
Motion is made in second to dissolve the meeting. All those in favor?
Aye.
Opposed? Nay. Thank you all for coming. And take a look at the art. I think you'll appreciate it.